Kids need nature and nature needs kids. Kids value the environment. They have a natural attraction to being outside and playing and learning outside, and they need that to be healthy, happy, and smart. One of the things that makes this region and Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore so unique is it's one of the most biologically diverse areas and one of the most biologically diverse national parks in all of the United States. My name is John Hayes. I'm the Executive Director of Dunes Learning Center. Dunes Learning Center is an environmental education center that has students overnight inside Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore. The students come here to learn about their relationship with the environment through education. So our education programs give them an experience that allow them to explore the history, natural history, cultural history of the region, and hopefully develop a strong appreciation for national parks and the environment. The Dunes Learning Center was opened and created in 1998 in partnership, in very close partnership really, with the Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore. Our facilities are located in Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore, and in 1998 a variety of different founders got together and developed the Learning Center and opened its doors in October of that year. Dunes Learning Center doesn't have a lot of indoor classroom space. In fact, we have no indoor classroom space, and that's because our classroom is the national park. We have 15,000 acres of, again, a most wonderful national park around, and it is becomes our classroom. There's several miles of hiking trails that we use with our students, all the way through Coles Bog, which is a four or five mile trail, beaches throughout the region, the dunes, Bailey Homestead and the Bailey Shelburg Farm area, all sorts of different hiking trails, the Little Calumet River Trail that goes around the Learning Center. We use all those spaces as our classroom. Our first set of programs are what we call our school programs, our school educational programs. And those are a variety of different programs, again, aimed at helping students and helping teachers learn about the environment and meet state and national standards. The one program, our flagship program, if you will, is called Frog in the Bog. It's a 2.5 day experience where kids come out along with their teachers and their school groups to learn about the Indiana Dunes region, the biodiversity here, and cultural and history, cultural and natural history of the region. The first day of the program, for example, is a bit of team building and community building and awareness. Later on, they go out and spend time at the Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore, is one of the historic areas called Bailey Shelburg Farm, and they go through what's called a walk through time, which is a really neat opportunity for them to explore the different human communities that lived here throughout the history of the region, starting with the Potawatomi Indians and the Miami Indians that lived in this region, moving through the French fur traders and so forth, Joseph Bailey, all the way up to the Shelburg Farm and the immigrant farmers that came into the region, and then of course now the National Park Service. The second day of Frog in the Bog is spent exploring the different ecosystems in the Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore. We take them on a wonderful trail called Coles Bog, where they explore a variety of different ecosystems. And so in a very short hike, students can see several different ecosystems, and of course we take advantage of that by doing what we call ecosystem investigations, which is a hands-on inquiry-based science lesson where they collect data and learn about the different ecosystems and then compare and contrast. High school program that we offer is called Dunescopes, and that is a program aimed at involving students not only in the science and learning about the environment, but also giving back to the environment. Our typical year starting for us in September, when the schools are back in session, and we will begin our school programs in the second or third week in September, when we begin with Frog in the Bog programs and so on. We then go through November with those frog in the bog type programs, and then in the end of November after Thanksgiving we begin our winter survival program. It's an opportunity for students and teachers to come out during the winter again overnight and learn about plant and animal adaptations to the environment. It's a wonderful time of year to be outside, actually, and that's one of the benefits, I think, of the program is many students who spend a lot of time indoors already get the opportunity to experience things outside at times of year when they may not otherwise be inclined to go outside. And when they leave this program, we've really opened some doors to some wonderful opportunities for them to be outside, particularly in the winter. In the summer, we sort of switch gears and begin to offer students a summer camp experience. Our summer camps are similar in mission to our school programs in that they are educationally based summer programs. So it's not your traditional summer camp where you might be doing mostly recreational activities. Our activities are still fun and still recreational, but there's also a learning component to them. We have students, again, from all over the region, including Chicago, that come to the Learning Center and immerse themselves in the dunes for environmental education type of experience. So when they come here, they are engaged in a variety of hands-on science activities, learning about the history and culture of the region, and really experiencing the dunes firsthand. There's a lot of different things that happen to a child during an experience like this. One of the most amazing things I think of, and this happens quite a bit, is we'll have students hiking to through the dunes on Coles Bog Trail, and they crest the top of that dune, and it might be the first time that they've really seen Lake Michigan, even though they may have grown up in the region. And when they hit the top of that dune and get the vista of Lake Michigan, there's usually a chorus of wows and oh my goodness. That's a rewarding thing to be a part of, for sure. The most rewarding part of my job is seeing the light bulbs go on. Seeing students that don't have a lot of opportunities to spend time outside come to a place like Dunes Learning Center and have a whole new world opened up to them. And I've yet to see a child that doesn't have a natural affinity for spending time outside. It may take a little while for some of them to get into it, but they usually do, and when that happens, that's an amazing thing to be a part of.